Hey, how's it going? Welcome back to ThinkView, and I'm Casper. So, in today's video, I want to share you 7 of the best Windows laptops that can replace the MacBook using the Apple Silicon, including the Air M1, the Air M2, the Pro 14, and the Pro 16. First is to show you how good Windows laptop is now, and secondly, if you are about to buy MacBook, this might make you think twice. Alright, so first, let's start with the MacBook Air M1. And the laptop that could be its replacement would be the ThinkPad X1 Nano Gen 1. And right now, on the market, it's at the same price as the MacBook Air M1. So why do I choose this laptop? Because the Apple Air M1 was launched a long time ago, and is still available on the markets as new. So I want to choose the top of the line laptop at that time, and it still got the brand new condition on the market. And especially, the price has gone down quite a lot ever since. But to be honest, being able to find that kind of device at this time would be a challenge, because such device would have a great build quality to extend the time. And speaking of build quality, plus not outdated design and having a huge fan base, the name that stands out in the Windows world is definitely ThinkPad. And the X1 Nano is the highest end of ThinkPad. It is exceptionally high quality and released around the same time with the MacBook Air. And one of the best features is how incredibly light it is, weighing just under 1 kg. It almost feels like weightless. Despite being so light, it's surprisingly sturdy. Even when you hold it by the edges, you won't see it flex at all. And you don't hear any weird noises that you might find in a cheaper laptop. The screen on this X1 Nano is 2K resolution. It's not the sharpest, but it's very comfortable to use. It has a touchscreen and can open up to 180 degrees so that you can share information with others easily. The touchscreen is handy for things like zooming in, especially if you are presenting something. The display quality is excellent, with 100% sRGB color coverage and brightness over 400 nits. Although the screen is glossy, but it's not as reflective as the MacBook Air. And because this is a high-end product, it's well designed with many nice details from big to small. As for the spec, it's used the 11th gen Intel processor. But trust me, you don't have to worry about the performance on this Ultrabook. The important thing is that it already comes with 16 gigs of RAM. I can work comfortably on it, just like a newer model. Maybe the chip could affect the battery life, and the truth is that the battery isn't very long lasting. It lasted almost 5 hours in our mixed use test at ThinkView, while the MacBook Air can last over 8 hours. The keyboards feel really good to type on, and it has a track point for controlling the cursor, which is a Lenovo exclusive feature. It also has both facial recognition and a fingerprint sensor. The only downside is that this is a fingerprint magnet. If it's not cleaned regularly or properly maintained, the chassis can become greasy over time. Otherwise, it is a still top-notch laptop even in 2024. But if you want something newer with better specs, you can check out the Dell Inspiron 5430. It has a more powerful i7 1360p processor, 16 gigs of RAM, 1 TB of SSD, and 2.5 screen with a 90Hz refresh rate, and very generous internal connectivity. Seems like a good deal, eh? However, this laptop is thicker and heavier. You can call it a feature for its durability, but its lack of sleek design and premium feeling. And the battery lasts about 5 hours because the Intel P-series chip focuses more on performance, not the use time. Alright, next up, as an alternative to the MacBook Air M2 and M3 this year, we have the very worthy name, the Surface Laptop 7. Available in 13-inch and 15-inch version with a Snapdragon processor, nearly on par with the MacBook Air 13 and 15-inch in almost every aspect, from performance, display, and build quality to sound system, battery life, and even the price. And in many places in the world, you can find it almost at the same price as the MacBook Air. Of course, there are some areas where the MacBook excel a bit more, and some where the Surface laptop does better. For example, the MacBook has better app compatibility since the Apple Silicon has been around 3 to 4 years. But on the other hand, the Surface has advantages like higher refresh rate screen, facial recognition, proximity sensor, and the default 16 gigs of RAM, which is a big plus. Additionally, within its price range in Windows laptop world, the Surface Laptop 7 hardly has any competition. replacement for the MacBook Pro 14, I have two recommendations. First, the Zephyrus G14 2024, and second, the Lenovo Slim 7 Pro X. Both are thin line laptops with clean design and powerful specs, ideal for content creator, photo editing, and of course, speaking of Windows laptop, they are even better for 3D rendering, workload, or gaming. Starting with the Zephyrus G14, it does have one issue that I will mention later. In terms of build quality, ROG has gone for a much more minimal design this year compared to the previous version. It's thinner, and the CNC detailing is more refined. However, it's still not as solid as the MacBook Pro 14. For example, the hinge can still feel a bit loose, and the aluminum chassis isn't as thick as on the MacBook or Razer. On the flip side, the G14 comes with 16GB of RAM and 1TB of SSD, a 3K OLED panel with 120Hz refresh rate, and all the tech you need for gaming, like G-Sync and NVIDIA Optimus. Also, with an RTX 4060, it can handle games with ease, since this is a very powerful graphic card. I think this is quite a good deal compared to the MacBook Pro 14. However, the issue that I've mentioned before was that this model is really rare on the market. The official version was only launched a few months ago, but now it's already hard to find. So, in addition to the Zephyrus G14, I want to suggest another option. That is the Lenovo Slim 7 Pro X. In terms of price, it's actually closer to the MacBook Air M2, costing just around $1,000 in my country. Yet, it offers an experience comparable to the MacBook Pro 14. It packed with the powerful specs, an AMD Ryzen 6900XS and RTX 3050 with 32GB of RAM and 1TB of SSD. Impressive, right? It's had a 14-inch glossy screen with a 120Hz refresh rate. The design is sleek and unique, with carefully crafted curves that feel and look great. This is an excellent laptop for those needing a device for graphic work or multimedia project at a moderate level. The battery lasts over 5.5 hours, which is decent for a Windows laptop. And finally, let's talk about a laptop that can replace the MacBook Pro 16. Currently in the Windows laptop world, I don't see any model that both aesthetically pleasing, compact yet sturdy, and as powerful as the MacBook Pro 16. Plus, the prices of comparable model like the Dell XPS 16, the Razer Blade 16, and the Zephyrus G16 are ridiculously high. Typically, people who buy the MacBook Pro 16 are those with heavy graphic design needs, requiring a very reliable machine that runs cool and quiet. But the model that I just mentioned don't fully deliver the kind of stable experience that lets you confidently focus on your work. So if you want to stick with Windows, in this case, I think that high-end gaming laptop is a good choice for you. They are more affordable, packed with more good stuff, much more powerful, and importantly, they offer better sustained performance. Of course, the trade-off would be that they look more like a gaming machine and are bulkier. Two models that I would recommend are the ROG Strix G16. You can get the 2023 version with an RTX 4070 for around $1,600 or the 2024 version as around $1,800 on Amazon. The second option is the Lenovo Legion 5 or the Lenovo Legion 5 Pro, depending on your budget. The price range from $2,000 to $2,500, depending on the configuration you choose. The downside is that they cannot maintain peak performance when running on battery. Plus, they are beefier and the battery life is kind of poor in comparison to the MacBook Pro. But in return, you get more for what you pay for. And that's it. Hope this will help you to pick the right laptop for you. But if all you care about was the battery life, check out our latest video where we make a battery showdown between Qualcomm, Intel, and Apple M series. Thanks for watching, and see you guys next time.